Welcome to Ulbricht's booth. My name is Thomas. I'm responsible for marketing and communication. Here we are at the DSEI in London 2023, and we are happy to introduce our ballistic helmets beyond the NH3A protection to the military customers. So not only special forces, also for land forces, because protection is not just a value add, protection is a mandatory part for the soldiers to come home if they get a hit. Ulbricht's is the only company in the world who is focusing on polytanium, material composition of titanium and polyethylene. So in this case, we don't take care of just the stopping effect, we also take care of the trauma, so of the residual kinetic energy transferred to the head. And so this is a mandatory part and the key to survive. So the explanation or the comparison between the Optio helmet and the NH3A helmet, the NH has a protection surface 50 millimeters from the rim, starting with stopping. And the Optio from Ulbricht's is focusing on the VPAM test standard, so the VPAM 3 HVN 2009, which is the handgun protection, 20 millimeters from the rim to 50 millimeters from the rim, you're stopping, and from 50 millimeters to the rim for the rest of the surface, you have also a trauma protection. The Optio Plus is our brand new model. It's just plus 300 grams, but 300 grams gives you additionally an increase of the protection surface. So already see it here in the comparison of the both Optio helmets. So both on the same standard. So the classical standard VPAM 3 HVN 2009 per definition and the definition beyond the VPAM standard. In comparison to the protection surface of an NH3A helmet, you see an increase which is ridiculous high in comparison to protecting against fragments and shrapnels to protecting against handgun ammunition. Here you see the comparison of a live demonstration we did together with Army Recognition, shooting at classical NH3A helmets with handgun, with hand grenade effect on a helmet at the soap head, which is still from which we still got over here. From the live demonstration, you see we have here about 50 joules. So 50 joules, you can imagine, is about dropping a 2 kilogram ball, 2 to 2.5 kilogram ball from 2 meters on your blanket head. So it's not survivable because the maximum values you survive is 25 joules. We also made a demonstration of what happens if you shoot on a helmet with a rifle ammunition. So even when you shoot with a 223, so caliber 5.56-45 on a helmet, on a classical handgun helmet, no handgun helmet in the world can stop this. And so for this, we also add an additional plate, so we call it the 40 shield, so you can bring a protection of a classical handgun helmet, which is already beyond the NH3A helmet, NH3A standard helmet, to a ballistic level where you also protect against Kalashnikov mild steel core and also up to caliber 308. You see the test result with the Ulbricht's helmets. So the comparison you see also here was the helmet with the hand grenade, shooting also then 2 times with a 9 millimeter, so a classical protection against handgun ammunition. And additionally to that, adding just the 40 shield to the helmet, to the stand Ulbricht's Optio helmet, whether it's the Optio or Optio Plus, you can upgrade this rifle protection to every handgun helmet. And so you can protect against caliber 223, you can protect against caliber 762 39 mild steel core, which is quite tough, and this is already a milestone in technology, and then also bringing it to a stopping and trauma protection level of caliber 308. And this is shot all on a distance of 10 meters with full speed. So already some special forces are trusting Ulbricht's, mainly police forces, and the biggest value add is the survivability. And so we want to bring the survivability and the protection to the head protection of the soldiers, whether it's a special force or it's a land force soldier. So it should be a mandatory part in every specification of military tenders, bringing in the survivability, because we want all to come home and get back to our beloved ones.